The last few Kanzashi videos have featured flowers made from cotton on a fairly large scale, about 3 inches in diameter. Today we're going to change things up a bit. We're going to work with silk and we're going to work with cotton again, but on a smaller scale. Neither of these are terribly difficult, though they do pose some challenges. Nothing that we can't overcome, and silk makes lovely flowers, and there's plenty of ways to use small Kanzashi flowers. It will be worth the effort, I promise, and it's really not all that difficult. We're going to start today with silk. This is some Habitai silk that I dyed using the Adirondack Color Wash Spray. And this is a flower that I made using some fabric cut from this piece. What I want to show you is how you can go about folding silk, and I'm going to work with 3-inch squares. And we're going to work with the folded petal from the book Kanzashi in Bloom. One of the things with silk is that it tends to want to flow and do its own thing. This petal, this purple petal, is made with the folded technique from the book. This silk petal was made the exact same way. The difference is that I finger creased the purple one as I was doing it with my fingers, and this one is, you cannot finger crease. It's not going to hold in place. You have to use a small iron. Now, I have one of these Clover mini irons. This is the mini iron 2. They get very hot, so obviously you have to be careful. In order to do this, we're going to work big rather than small. We're going to start with these 3-inch squares, and we're going to fold a petal that looks like this. And ultimately, you'll make a bunch of petals so that you have a flower that looks like this. And then I'm going to show you, I'm not real happy with this color, I'm going to show you how you can come back after the fact and add color and make this look however you want it to. Here's my 3-inch square of Habitai silk. Now, I'm not demonstrating the folding technique so much as I am how to make the silk behave. You can learn the folding technique directly from the book. Again, this is the folded petal. Silk will not finger crease and stay. This is not like cotton at all, and so the right way to work around that is to come in here and use the mini iron. Now, all I'm doing is just lightly pressing this. I want to get this flat so that there's a crease in there, and now I can actually work with this. The next step is to fold this over. Now, when you make this petal, this point back here where the two folds meet is going to be the point of the flower. You want to be as accurate as possible because the silk is slippery and it's not going to want to do exactly what you want it to. Now, you've noticed that I've used that iron the entire time here. Eventually, I'm going to stop using the iron, but initially I am going to because I want to get these creases done and I want them to get in there well. Again, I'm taking special care down here because this is the point of my flower and I want it to be nice and pointy. Alright, I've made those basic folds, and then the next step on this petal is to bring these side pieces up like this. Now, this is where I'm not going to use the iron. I like the look that I get, and here's the finished petal. I like this more open, loose look rather than this. Now, I could attempt this with the silk. The problem is that it's so slippery that I'm never going to get this nice straight fold in here. And so I compromise with this petal that I like just as much. A group of them together makes a flower that looks like this. Here's our silk flower. And this flower, this smaller version, started out looking much like this. As I said earlier, I'm not real happy with the color that this came out, but I can fix that after the fact. And what we're going to do is, this is Color Wash, this is Wild Plum, and that was one of the colors I used initially to dye the Habitai silk. I want this to be a little bit more pink, a little bit more golden peach than it is right now yellow, which is far too yellow. So I'm going to come in, I'm going to wet my brush, and this is one of these little round wells that holds paint. I put some water in it, and then I dipped a little bit of color wash in it to just darken the paint a little bit, and you'll have to play with that to decide how concentrated you need it, but I can tell you it's a lot of water to very little color wash because it's very strong. So now that my brush is wet, I'm going to come in and I'm going to pick up some of this color wash, and I'm just going to brush it on the petals. And what I'm trying to do is to get some pink in here. If I end up with, and I'm going to show you here, I have some pink off to one side that is pretty much straight out of the bottle. If I end up with something like this that I don't like, don't panic. As long as this is wet, you can come in with some water, you can kind of flood the petal, and the color will spread out. And at the end, this probably will look really nice because flower petals in nature aren't all 100% the same color from top to bottom, and so this will look a little bit more like that. And all you need to do is come around and add some of this mix to wherever you think you want this to be a little bit more pink. Now, again, I might want this color to fade out a little bit as it gets down toward the petal so that it fades from this pink color to a more gold color. And what I'll do is just come in with water on the brush, and I'm going to brush this out and bleed the color down toward the tip of the petal a little bit. It's really very simple, not difficult at all, and you can do really cool things with this. There's lots of options for changing color, and though this is silk, you can do this on cotton too if you like. If you're going to make flowers small, and in this case I'm talking this one is 1 1/8 inches and this one is 1 1/4 inches, you really need to work with the iron. Anything else and your life is not going to be fun, so my suggestion is that you get yourself one of these irons. This flower in this size will work great on a barrette or on a doll, on a handbag. I have a bag that I'm thinking of using this one on. I mean, there's lots of little things that you can do with these. The key to working with stuff this small is to be as accurate as possible and to use an iron. So here's one of my 1 1/4 inch squares, and I'm going to fold a round Kanzashi petal. Again, you got to be super accurate, so you want to be certain that you're correct, that all your corners match up, and then you're just going to lightly touch this iron and make that fold. The next fold on a round petal is down like this, and again I'm going to come in with my iron and set that fold in place, and then my next one will bring the corner down like this. And if you can get in here close and see, once I press this, you'll notice that this is a tight little square, and you can't, virtually cannot see the seam on it because I've made this such a perfect little square, and that's important. The next step is going to be to flip that over, and now you're going to imagine a vertical line from point to point, again with your seam like this. Fold the corner into that imaginary vertical line. Hold it with just the tip of your fingernail, or a pin if you don't have fingernails, and hit it with the iron. You're not going to make it stay, but you're going to press it so it's going to remember that shape. Turn it around and do that again. And once that cools, you have to give it a second because it's going to be hot. Pick it up. Oops. Don't drop it. Fold that last fold in, and then you have this tiny, tiny little petal. And the two that I made each have 8 petals on them. They make nice little flowers that way. They're compact and they're not loose and floppy, and you can do a lot of things with them. This flower was modeled after the one on the cover of Kanzashi in Bloom, and like the author Diane Gilliland, and my apologies if I'm massacring her name, we're going to take and turn this flower into a adornment to hang off of a bag. This is going to be for Jess. So the first thing you have to do, I have a length of chain that I've attached a lobster claw to using a jump ring, and I have 2 eye pins. Each of them has a jump ring on the end as well. I have a circle of wool felt that we cut out, and what we're going to do is arrange the eye pins on the wool felt like this. We're going to glue them in place, and then once the glue has set a little bit, we're going to flip it over and we're going to put it on the back of the flower. All right, I'm going to lay these eye pins in now. And I'm probably going to add a little bit more glue over the top. I want to just be certain that they don't pull out. There's no real top or bottom to this flower, so how I lay that on there really doesn't matter. I'm just going to turn this over. Now these eye pins are not aligned perfectly right now, but I'm going to fuss with that once I actually get them on the flower. Simply lay this over the center, tap it into place, and now I'll arrange these eye pins so that they're sticking out equally from the top of that pin. Ordinarily, I would wait until this were dry, but I do want to just show you how this is going to go together. I'm going to find, if I could get my fingers on it, I'm going to find the jump ring, turn it to where I can get to it, open it up, I'm just going to quickly close this part way with my fingers. No, I'm not. It's going to argue with me, so I'll do it the right way. Okay. This is all on. Again, I like the way these are aligned. And now this chain is attached. You have the lobster claw, hook it around your purse, clip it on here, and you're good to go. I know most of us probably know a little girl who would like some sort of a Kanzashi hair clip, and this is a little hair clip kind of thingy, and we'll have these. This is a flower that I made actually for the last video. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use the Aileen's, the thick designer tacky glue, and I'm going to glue this piece on here. Now I'm going to do this in such a way that one of these petals will conceal this part right here that you pinch to make it open, and then I'm going to glue the rest of this in place. You will see a little bit of the barrette piece sticking out from underneath the petal. There's not too much you can do about that. You need to be able to allow yourself the manual dexterity with that petal in place or the flower in place to be able to open and close this, so you sort of have to compromise a little bit on it. When I glue this, I'm going to glue this and I'm going to leave it upside down like this because I think if I turn this over, the flower is going to have a tendency to slide out of the way. So I'm going to use the tacky glue and I'm going to fairly liberally spread this on here, but not so much that it's going to creep out. And then I'm going to put it on this flower, making certain that I've got it centered on that petal, and I'll take that glue out of there. And if you look at it, you can see that this is what we end up with. Now, having said that, I am, as I said, I'm going to turn it and leave it like this. I'm going to leave it propped against something so that this stays in place. And it's that quick and easy. This was made with the Clover Flower Maker, the small pointed flower, just in case you wanted to know. This is a more standard style barrette, what you're probably used to seeing. You just pinch it, the bottom pops open, you put it in your hair, you clip it closed. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put this flower on it. Now this flower actually is big enough to cover this whole thing, but if you should happen to have a barrette that's not, or if you want to be a little bit extra fussy, you can do what I've done. I've cut a piece of wool felt that this barrette will fit on, and because Jess nagged me, I rounded the corners so it looks nice and pretty. I'm going to glue this felt to the barrette. I'm just going to dab a little glue on there, set it on the felt, and then once that's dry, we'll glue the flower on the back, just like we did the other one. Just kind of rock that, because these barrettes are curved. Let this sit. Once it is, glue your flower on the back, and again, you're done. And now this is quite a bit bigger, but for a grown-up girl or a girl who wants something big, it works just great.